Okay, my brother, I've got a question for you. The question I have is, you know, we have a Muslim, for African Muslim, right? They go to Arab countries, right? And they, you know, all the time they treat badly, and they call like names as, you know, Abid, yeah. And they, I mean, I don't know how to explain it, but like, can you please explain to us and why when Muslim followers go to an Arab country, right, they got treated badly?
Bana, this is what we are here about. You see, the ruler of our country, of the Muslim country, are so corrupted. They are kuffar made in kuffar land. All our rulers are made in kuffar land, and they are there for two reasons: to live like kings and to screw the Islam and make it looks bad. One of the big thing to make Islam looks bad is to attack Africans. Why? Because this is something, the biggest shameful thing is you go against the Quran. Allah said in Quran, "Kuntum khayra umma." You are the best nation. Innama al-mu'minuna ikhwa. All the believers are brother and sister. لا فرق بين عربي وأعجمي. There's no difference between Arab or non-Arab except by piety. All these things is written. But when you go against that, Islam is fake. So how you do that? They bring bastard from Arabia, bring him to there, to here. When they are young, they give them drugs, they give them alcohol, they make party, heroin, and they take video. And they put in the drawer. 5, 6, 10 years, the little boy grown up. And he forgot about the CD. And this man now becoming Amir or something in the government. They tell him, you have to listen to us. And he said, no, I am Muslim and Arab. They tell you, some, you son of a gun. You remember this CD? They wanted us to show it? And you have to follow them.
That is the reason, like, African, like, get treated badly.
African, Asian, yes?
I understand.
I've been in Arabia. I saw how they treat Pakistani and Bengali and Indian. To show you that the Saudi ruler and the Gulf ruler are the biggest boss in the whole world. Why they employing maybe 250,000 Indian worshipping the cow? The Indian, when they destroy the Babri Mosque and they kill 2,000 person one day. Why do you don't get Africans? Why do you don't get Pakistani or Burmese? This is part of the plot. I lived in Arabia. Unfortunately, I lived in Mecca. And I saw how the African people called Takruni. And I don't know this Takruni is a tribe from Nigeria or something like that. But you cannot, in Islam, you cannot tell people, you are Zulu, you are Maasai, you are brother. Brother, I can't tell you Zulu. If I tell you Zulu, I have to say it. You are the lion of the forest. Because the Zulu, how do you live? How do you live? They don't have machine guns. They go for hunt. You know the Zulu child is raised like the Muslim. But not this comeback Muslim. The Zulu, when he become a man, they send them to the forest. Bye-bye, 40 days. And tell him, after 40 days, come back. When he come back, they make him get married. Why? Because he's the man, lived with the animal, lived off the land, lived off the forest, and he is now he can have a charge. But now, look at the Arab children, brother. Wallahi al-azim, the cartoon, you know, the Simpson and the Tilly Bobs and this stuff. And they tell you, don't speak about it. You are a clown. You are less than a clown. At least the clown make people happy. When I look at you, you make me sad. Remember, brother, Indonesia and Malaysia became Muslim without fighting. They saw the Muslim, the real Muslim manner. I want to ask you now a question. How Omar ibn al-Khattab, radiallahu anhu arda, Khalid ibn al-Walid, Abu Ubaidah, all these Sahaba raised by Kafir woman. How the Muslim woman raising these scumbags? Muawiyah, Akrimah ibn Abi Jahl. These people raised by Kufar woman. How come, ask yourself, how a Kafir woman raised a lion and a Muslim woman raised a pig? And from that answer, you know the situation. This, I'm going to tell you a miracle now. The Prophet ﷺ, 1450 years ago, said, "Tatada'a alaykum al-umam, nation will come upon you and eat you as if you are in a pot." And the Sahaba went crazy. How come? They were few. 500, 1,000, 2,000. And said, "Are these women fewer than us?" He said, "No. At the time, they're going to be plenty. Assalamu alaikum, brother. But they are sluts." That's what you see here. Assalamu alaikum. Islam is peace. What peace, you son of a gun? What peace? And Islam, nothing left out of it except even the name is fake. Now the kafir knows Islam better than the scum Muslim. The kafir, wallahi, knows the real Islam than the scum Muslim. Because the Muslim doesn't know ku'u from bu'u. He doesn't know his backside from anything. Allah. And this is, brother, subhanallah, this is a big opportunity. When you have people coming from thousands of miles to do Hajj. Jazakallah khair. May Allah bless you. May Allah bless you. May Allah bless you. Wallahi, brother, I don't think cold. Cold my throat. I got problem. May Allah bless you. Brother, now ask yourself, what an opportunity someone come to live with you, to show him, why you come to this dirt? Why? An African man coming to your house, working year and year, 2 years. Don't talk about Islam. Let him watch you. You coming to talk to this filth, coming every week. My Bible, the word of God, Jesus, the word is Jesus, and Jesus is God, and Jesus. Why, brother? Why you waste your time? Hajj, where you find opportunity, 2-3 million coming to you. Wallahi, I'm going to say this for the dirty bastard of Arabia. Wallahi, this happened from my friend, he's West Indian. He was in a taxi, definitely with a Saudi driver, because there's no foreigner drive taxi. And the driver said the car broke down. Give us a push. Wallahi, this is from brother. I trust him like more than all it in the corner. He pushed the taxi and the driver gone with his wife. And astaghfirullah, may Allah forgive me, may Allah forgive me. He done bad business with the woman. And the woman went to the police station. And the bastard officer wouldn't believe her. And you wonder, people going out of Islam? Because you dirty bastard. I live in Mecca. Wallahi, I lived in Mecca. In the every day, you know, around Mecca, there's so many water wells and dried. The police every day make round to see who is dead. Because the criminal, they get rid of each other and they push each other in the water well at night. Is this the, where? Don't tell me, Kaaba. Don't tell me. You behave like, where the, wallahi, monkeys have mercy than you. Wallahi, monkeys are more blessed. You are cursed. You push people out of Islam by your arrogancy. Go to hell, you and your money. Don't you remember Nugush and Nagashi? May Allah bless him. Didn't Nagashi save the Muslim da'wah at the beginning? Is that the way you paid him back, you scumbag? You remember Osman ibn Affan, radiallahu anhu arda? You remember Umm Habiba, the Prophet alayhi salam wife, radiallahu anhu? You remember Ja'far al-Tayyar and names? Is that the way to pay them back? Brother, my advice to you, look, follow Islam, not the Muslims. Because Allah make it clear. If you follow, أولئك المؤمنون حقا أولئك الصادقون. In the Quran, there's a believer and true believer. I want you to search who's the true believer. You believe. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. Help you instant, in the minute. After that, it doesn't help you.
How would help you then?
You have to move on. When you say لا إله, what does إله mean? Allah means the thing you are drawn to, not inclined to man or to like to woman, inclined to Allah all the time. So la ilaha mean I am not inclined to anything all the time except to Allah. And I have to know Allah names and Allah attributes, and I have to achieve it. And who's Muhammad? Who's Muhammad alayhi salam? A man? No. I have to know his biography. I have to know how he suffered. I have to know how he brought to me Islam. I have to follow him. I have to be tested like him. You don't chill out at home and say, oh, I am like Muhammad. No, you bugger. No. No. Look at this. I'm going to say bastard. The bastard denying something very big in Islam. He said there is no jihad. And the Prophet said, jihad continuously in my nation till the day of judgment. So, do you believe in some in the books? And you leave, is it disco? You think Islam is disco? You go and pick up what you like and you leave what you like? Brother, for the brothers who had difficulty from the Arabian, don't worry, this is test for you. If you are a Muslim, if I see a bad Muslim, I'm not going to abandon Islam. I'm going to abandon the scum who say he's a Muslim. Because Islam is not claim, brother. I told you, you can't claim you are a Muslim for 1 second. And after that, you have to prove it. As long as you're going, you have to prove it. What you gonna say when you read Quran? إنما المؤمنون إخوة. What you gonna do with the African? Did he said, believer a brother except the African? يا أيها الذين آمنوا إنا خلقناكم من ذكر وأنثى. You are son of Adam. Doesn't matter your color. I'm son of Adam. Our father is one. So who makes you better or me better? Unless I'm raped. There's some people, I'm gonna correct it. There's some people raped in head, and some people love to be raped. They are intellectually prostitute. They go every day and get raped in their head. And these people, brother, don't take them. Be strong, brother. This, everything in life is test. And wallahi, when I go around London, I feel bad.
Why?
I have in some photo of African women and men and West Indian say Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. And I feel very bad. I have soft heart for the African. Not because I'm African. Because they are oppressed. And Islam, number one target of Islam is to lift oppression on people and to help the oppressed people. And I don't know how come these African people or West Indian turning to the people who stole, every exploit them for years and export that the slave trade, 400 million. Why they going there? And the Muslim never, assalamu alaikum, exploit Africa, never.
But what is like, you know, I have another question with you as well. Like, you know, you just remind me, you know what I mean, killing, you know what I mean, Muslim and Muslim, yeah? For example, like in Sudan, we call like, in West Sudan, right? We got a region called Darfur, right? You just remind me what's going on there. Like that area, everyone is Muslim, right? So.
Brother, I got a question. Mm-hmm. Can a Muslim fight a Muslim?
No.
Yes. What's the evidence? Quran. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وإن طائفتان من المؤمنين اقتتلوا. If two groups among Muslims fight each other, فأصلحوا بينهما. Try to make peace between them. فإن بغت إحداهما على الأخرى. If a one was tyrant and going against. فقاتلوا التي تبغي حتى تفيء لأمر الله. Fight, a Muslim should fight the oppressed group who fight. But brother, we are slave. Look what happened in Sudan. Why did they divide South Sudan and North Sudan? The oil. Who done this? The British. Who get the Sudanese killed? The British. Why to exploit the oil? Darfur. Who is Hamiti and the other guy? What's his name? Al-Burhan. Mana, these people are implanted. And they tell you, don't go against the ruler. Yes? Why the Saudi went against the ruler in Egypt? Why the Saudi bastard went against the ruler in Libya? Why the Saudi bastard went against Najibullah in Afghanistan? Is it not Khawarij? But the bastard went there to help the American. And when you go to Sudan, you're not helping the Muslim. You're not helping the Sudanese. You're helping the enemy. This factory for weapon have to be running. Someone have to buy weapon all the time. Someone have to buy medicine. There's no room for improvement. Libya, one of the richest countries in the world. They bloody begin. Algeria, one of the most rich countries in the whole world. All of them running refugee. Africa, man, you know, why France, the Francophone, why France control 56 countries in Africa? Why most of the African countries use the French franc? Why most of the Africans speak French? Where's your language? They rape you. They rape your culture. They rape your brain. They rape everything till you speak the language. And eat courroisa and salizon and the shit, couscousé. We have to wake up, brother. We have to bring lions. We have to produce one lion, not million. Pigs. Dogs. Wallahi. Some dogs are more honorable than men, Muslim men. You know why? Because the dog, when you tell him, stand here, he will defend here. And Allah tell you defend. What are you defending? We need lion or lioness. We need people to stand up. You cannot, brother, the first problem you drop, you cannot drop the thing. You cannot drop it. Ask him before I go, man.
Have you got any question, right? Because my concern is about, you know what I mean? As African, we go to our fellow Muslim brother country, right? I mean, and then we got like, it's really hard for us to take that. And the whole world touched it. Just like weeks ago, more than 200 Africans got killed by, you know, as you call it, Moroccan police, by the Moroccan government. And like, no one even talk about it. Like, majority of those victims are Muslims. And no sheikh or mufti, no one else talk about anything about that. And like, more than 200 people have just like got killed by the Moroccan government, and no one talk about it. Like, why is it?
Respect yourself. Your enemy is not gonna respect you. Don't leave Africa, brother and sister. Don't leave it. Allah give you. Stay there. Improve. Don't go to Hajj. In my neck. Don't go to Hajj. Don't go. Don't give your money to the bastard Saudi. Don't give it.
Hajj is fard. How come you can't go?
Brother, fard, sometimes saving a Muslim life is more fard than Hajj. Because if you don't have money, Hajj is not compulsory to you. Before the time of Hajj come, speak to Allah. Tell him, Allah, you send prostitute to Jannah because she saved a dog. I'm going to save Muslims. I'm going to dig water well. Give me the reward of Hajj. If you go to Hajj, the Saudi bastard will bring your money here in Britain. They buy football club. They buy palaces. They come and look at the Saudi woman here. All of them is nice. Why? Don't. Stay in your country. Keep your money. Use it in a good deed. Use it in a good deed. Allah will reward you. Improve your country. Africa, mashallah. Been there for thousands of years and going to be thousands of years.
Yeah, but like,
country now is looking for the wealth you have. Mineral and gas and uranium and everything.
But the problem, people, why leave Africa, especially like Darfurians, right? You know, we have the government supporting the other side of tribe, what they call Arabs. You know, I mean, the Hemeti and other groups, right? The government supporting them. But the people who are like me, who are not Arabs, right? We don't have a power to follow this face them. They come and like rape, yeah, kill and do all of that. So this is why people leave the countries. It's not by choice. So how can, yeah, we survive?
When you are strong, why you leave? When you are strong, Allah test you, brother. You telling me if you run away here, you're not gonna be tested? You cannot escape the test. If you go underground, you will be tested. If you go to the heaven, to the sky, you will be tested. If you go to the sea, you will be tested. But what happens if we all run away? There's no matter. I wish I was young. I will never leave Egypt. I left Egypt 1979. Alhamdulillah, never been there. But I done my duty in other places. I work, brother. I work hard. I made a lot of money. Alhamdulillah. I'm blessed. Halal money. And halal money could take you all the way. If all these bastards saying, if I am not protected from the Almighty, I should be roasted and roasted and roasted now. وَيُخَوِّفُونَكَ بِالَّذِينَ مِنْ دُونِهِ. They try to make you scared with the filth. We don't scare from the filth. We scare from the Almighty. The more you go in the sake of Allah, the more strength He will give you. The more blessing He will give you. And we promise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to stand fast. We have nothing. This tongue from Allah. This hand from Allah. This brain from Allah. This money from Allah. This legs from Allah. He gave me everything, and I'm using some of what He given me in His way. Where I go wrong? May Allah bless you, man. May Allah protect you. And you're the duty, brother. When an African brother or sister speak to you about that, you have to give them hope, to tell them Islam. We are non-African, or I'm African, but I'm not dark-skinned. We are sovereign. The Saudi bastard in the comment, they said you are non-Arab. You are this. Do I care? When I go in the Day of Judgment, Allah is not going to ask me, are you Arab or non-Arab? It doesn't matter. Abu Jahl, brother, the Pharaoh of the Ummah was Arab. Abu Lahab was Arab. Utbah ibn Rabi'ah, Arab. Shaiba, all this tyrant was Arab. Where they gone? In the sewage of history. Tell the mother, the enemy raped the Arabs in their head for so many hundreds of years, more than 100 years. And when you get, wal'azhu billah, when you get raped, everything was AIDS. Everything coming out of their head, AIDS. We need a real lion, marry real lioness, produce a cub. A little lion, grown up to be lion, doesn't know how to bow down. Lion only eat fresh meat. Lion work hard. He doesn't have holiday. He doesn't have sick bay. Every morning he's in the hunt. May Allah bless you, man. Assalamu alaikum.
Jazakallah khair.
Thank you.